Next class, we are going to discuss about the next phase of the compiler, which is intermediate code generation. So, the compiler, the phases of a compiler is basically divided into two, that is front end and back end, or it is divided into the analysis phase and the synthesis phase. So, the front end of a compiler, in the analysis synthesis model of a compiler, we have two ends, or the compiler is divided into two. Working of the compiler is divided into two phases. One is the front end. Front end means the phases from source program to the intermediate code generation. Intermediate representation is comprises the front end, and the back end comprises of the machine independent code optimization and generation of target code. So this is how we divide the phases of a compiler into. Now we have some advantages of dividing the phases of a compiler into two. So the first advantage is retargeting is facilitated. Retargeting means is facilitated means we once we have once we have formed the front end, after that we can map the code into different instructions. That is, if suppose for a processor P1, we have produced a front end, and if you want to generate the machine code for processor P1, then we can produce the code for P1, and if you want to produce the code for a processor P2, so P1 and P2 they will be having different instruction set, right? So you have the front end with you. Front end is you have the front end with you. Now this front end can be reused. That is, for processor 1 you can use the same front end, and for processor to produce a code in processor 2, you can use the same front end. Okay, you needn't again compile. You didn't need to do the lexical phase again, the syntax phase again, the semantic phase. All those things needn't be done. So that is, the reusability of the front end is one of the main advantages of dividing the phases of the compiler into two. Understood? Now that is, retargeting is facilitated with the help of existing front end. Different machine backends can be created. Now, second one is machine independent code optimization can be applied to intermediate representation. So after once a front end has formed, you will be having the code. Your source program will be converted into some intermediate representation. Again, you are able to perform, or the compiler is able to perform any code in the machine independent code optimization. So code optimizations are again classified into two. One is machine dependent and machine independent code optimization, and it is an optional phase also in compilation process. So since we have the front end, after that, since it doesn't depend on the back end, we can do the machine independent code optimization also, which will be discussed in the next module. Okay, so that is, these are the two advantages of breaking the compiler phases into two. Now we can see the position of intermediate code generator. So the position of intermediate code generator is here, right? So your first phase, the source program, is given to the lexical analyzer. Again, tokens will be produced as output. It is again given as input to the parser. Again, the parser will generate the syntax tree. Again, we will give it to the static checker. Static checker or the semantic analyzer. Again, you will get the corrected parse tree or syntax tree as the output. Okay, or the annotated parse tree as the output. Again, that will be given as input to the intermediate code generator, and the intermediate code generator will generate the intermediate code or intermediate representation, which will be given to the code generator. Or if you have the optimization phase, then it will be given to the code optimizer. Okay, so in the next video we will discuss about what are the intermediate representation, what are the forms of intermediate representations.